So sleep has been studied for over 100 years, right? And we still really don't know what it does. And so we're very interested in my lab in understanding the purpose of sleep. I'm Susan Harbison. I'm a quantitative geneticist at the National Heart, Lung, and Blood Institute. We research sleep duration, the time spent sleeping in fruit flies. We're trying to understand the genetic architecture of sleep, and in so doing, understand its overall purpose. We were trying to understand and identify candidate genes involved in very long and very short sleep times. We wanted to know if there were underlying changes in the fly's DNA to see if we could drive sleep duration up or down. So we started with a natural population of flies, and we split that natural population of flies into six populations, two that we selected for long sleep duration, two that we selected for short sleep duration, and two unselected controls. And then each generation, we measured sleep on 100 males and 100 females in each population. And to breed for long sleep, we chose the longest sleeping 25 males and 25 females as parents for the next generation. We did the same thing for short sleep, and we repeated that process over many generations. As we were going along, we were sequencing their DNA. We looked at how the DNA changed over time and whether or not that was a signal for long and short sleep times. We found some extreme differences in the sleep phenotypes. The long sleepers slept 17.8 hours on average in a 24-hour period. The short sleepers slept 3.3 hours in a 24-hour period. And the underlying DNA also changed dramatically with selection. We used a statistical technique called a logistic regression, and that enabled us to identify 80 genes that were different between the long sleepers and the short sleepers. Those genes are part of development and signaling pathways that were not previously appreciated to be involved in sleep duration. And furthermore, most of the genes that we found in flies are also present in both mice and humans. So we think that these genes are highly conserved, and that means that they have a functional role, not only in flies, but potentially also in humans. This will help us understand what the larger purpose of sleep actually is. And if we understand the purpose of sleep, we can then understand its role in human health. So we're hoping that with the genes that we discovered, that researchers will be able to take those genes and identify therapeutic targets for sleep disorders.